always hoped that one day we'd be able to help the whole of the island with malaria control. And the reason for that is, I feel, most clearly illustrated by the case of Celestiana.
Waiting on an angel, one to carry me home. Hope you come.
Celestiana's parents come from Kodi. It's 80 kilometers from Nihiwatu. They come to see me with their really sick daughter, Celestiana. They asking me for some food because they hear about our malnutrition program and food program.
She came from the hospital that unfortunately didn't treat her with the correct medicine, so she continued to have the malaria, and actually they didn't help her very much.
She's paralyzed, she cannot speak, and she's just crying.
Angel, hear my plea.
We want to make a quick impact, not just on Sumba, but on the whole region here. We need to improve the skills of the microscopists. Klaus has been working very hard on this. It's been a huge effort.
The Goldman Sachs Bank has given us a grant to start a malaria microscopy training center. So this means a center that can certify malaria microscopists from all over Sumba with a full certification. This is a huge first step in the direction of providing good diagnosis for all the clinics on Sumba Island, all the government clinics, all the private clinics, and all the hospitals.
It's going to be something that's amazing, and something that's very important, and something that's going to save thousands of lives.
Angel, hear my plea. Take my hand, lift me up so that I
bring her directly to our clinic.
And in last effort of desperation, when she was most atrophied, we immediately diagnosed her and cured her and helped her with nutrition.
And I'm waiting on an angel, and I know it won't be long.
We put her in malnutrition program, giving her milk, eggs, vitamin also every day.
We continue to operate extremely lean, with 90% of all donations going directly to programs, try and direct the most dollars to having the largest impact.